has been 13 months since Katy Perry's song California Girls first entered the top 10. Since then, not a day has gone by that a Katy Perry song has not been present in the top 10. 13 straight months of Katy Perry. There have been presidential administrations that didn't last that long. Now, I've made no secret that I think Katy Perry is noxious, but longtime viewers of my show might also remember that I put two Katy Perry songs on my top 10 list last year.
I'm sorry. I am so sorry.
Well, as I expected, I was immediately blasted for it from many people, including and especially from my own colleagues. And now, a short montage of people giving me shit for my top 10 list. The reactions are real. Names and faces have not been changed to protect the innocent because I'm lazy.
Todd, I've got Miley Cyrus on my MP3 player, and even I'm disgusted by your taste in music.
Todd, you apologized 15 times for putting California Girls on your list. 15 times isn't enough.
Why would anybody like Katy Perry? She sounds like a garbage truck in labor.
This is what the music guy on the site listens to. The music guy.
Stop stealing pieces of my hair.
Yeah, Katy Perry sure does suck. But I stand by my statements. It's not that I think those are bad songs, I think they're very good songs, despite the fact that I don't like Katy Perry as a person or an artist at all. Even Firework, which I criticized heavily in a previous episode, I will admit I still think that's actually a pretty decent song. Oh, by the way, hope you all had a good 4th of July. Be prepared to hear that song every Independence Day for the rest of your lives. But then she released E.T., her fourth and, by far, worst single off her latest album. E.T. is the first Katy Perry song since I Kissed a Girl that I didn't like even the tiniest bit.
You know, actually, I kind of like that song.
Shut up, nostalgia chick! Whatever.
Call me.
Yeah. Alright. Like I said, I don't like this song. And oh, thank you, Lord in heaven, what a blessed relief that is for me. I don't have to feel guilty about how much I like E.T., because I don't! I can safely say that this song is awful. What a load off of my mind. So let's look at the new abomination of a single from that brain-dead, squawking, grating voice excuse of a pop singer known as Katy Perry. Oh, hi Kanye. Okay, apparently Katy Perry's handlers weren't convinced that the song could be successful on its own, so the version of this song that got popular is a remix with Kanye West on it. In recent years, Kanye has become one of the go-to rappers who can push a song over the top commercially, and there's very few other rappers who can claim that. Really, the only people who can say that are Jay-Z, Lil Wayne, and Ludacris, but even they can't claim to be able what Kanye can do. See, no one else has ever managed the feat of becoming an on-demand guest rapper while completely sucking at it. Everybody on your dick, no homo. Super sad chicks giving me mixed loving. So we can finally fly off into NASA. Generally, you take off from NASA, not into it, Kanye. Look, I like Kanye, or Yeezy, as he likes to call himself, but I really don't understand why anyone else puts him on their own songs. He's really compelling when he's dealing with his own personal psychoses, when he's pouring his guts out, you know? But he's not one of those guys who can just toss off a verse whenever someone needs one. He always sucks. Always. Two lines into E.T. and the verse is unsalvageable. I got a dirty mind, I got filthy ways, I'm trying to bathe my aid in your Milky Way. I'm a legend, I'm okay, see, according to every internet site I consulted, believe me, I consulted a lot of them, what Kanye is saying is bathe my eight in your Milky Way. I'm trying to bathe my eight in your Milky Way. That can't possibly be the case. And if it is, Kanye, there's an art to sexual innuendo. You gotta have some kind of sense. You can't just take a vaguely sexual sentence and throw random words into it. And that's not even the worst lyric on the verse. They calling me an alien, a big-headed astronaut. Maybe it's because your boy Yeezy get ass a lot. I have so many questions about that line. Obviously, big-headed astronaut is not and has never been a term used by anyone to describe a guy who has a lot of sex, so is Kanye trying to turn that into an expression? I don't see it catching on. And for that matter, what does big-headed mean in that sentence? Are people calling Kanye big-headed, and when he asks what they mean, they say, oh, it just means you're good with the ladies, Kanye. Oh, and as for Kanye getting ass a lot, all I have to say about that is that I'd like everyone to listen to Runaway, the lead-off single from his most recent album. Find pictures in my email. I sent this bitch a picture of my dick. I don't know what it is with females, but I'm not too good at that shit.
see. Oh, Kanye, you big-headed astronaut, you. Okay, well, here we get into the song proper. If you didn't gather from Kanye's lyrics, or the video, or Katie's amazing hairdo here, this song has an aliens theme. Specifically, Katie sings about being in love with a weird someone or something who's not human and from a whole other world. Considering who she's married to, yeah, that sounds about right. And the whole thing is about this amazing hot alien guy and all his amazingly hot sexual alien powers, I guess. Basically, she's singing about the Jeff Goldblum alien in Earth Girls Are Easy. Wait a minute. Is it supernatural or is it extraterrestrial? Can't be both unless you're messing around with a vampire alien or a alien ghost. Lame. Okay, yes, the idea of sex with aliens can be hot. Our species has a long, fine history of interplanetary sex. But I do want to say, I'd perhaps find the song a little more attractive if they hadn't named the song after the ugliest, most asexual alien in history. At least I'm pretty sure he was asexual, unless I missed something in that movie. Where's that finger, Ben? That's a pretty unsexy imagery, right? No one's turned on by that. Unless there's some kind of weirdo who's aroused by that bug-eyed turd of an alien. Fortunately, I think I can say with all certainty that there is no one turned on by E.T. Because if there was, it had to be some kind of porno version of E.T. And I'm sure if there was, I would have heard about it by now. And if I didn't mention it, I'm sure my comment section would be flooded with people telling me about the E.T. porno. God, that'd be awful. Good thing one doesn't exist, huh? Okay, well, E.T. may be ugly, but you know what's uglier? This song. I'm a traditionalist, I like my pop songs catchy. E.T. just kind of stomps on you. Could you be the devil? Could you be an angel? Your touch, magnetizing. Physically imploding, leaves my body glowing. Sing it, we will rock you. Oh, I wish, Freddy. I imagine Katy Perry's producers wrote this migraine of a song simply because they were sick of coming up with these very pretty frameworks and fine-tuning every detail and then trying to figure out how to auto-tune Katy Perry's unstomachable singing voice to fit in it. Well, screw that! No more trying to stretch and filter the worst voice in pop music into some kind of listenable sound. Nope, we're just gonna let her out at full blast! Your problem to deal with now, America! And a catchy tune? With that voice? Oh, hell no. We're done trying to find something she can sing. Just let her beat the melody into submission. And that's for the choruses and the verses. E.T. sounds like if they let 3 Days Grace write pop songs. There's not even really much of a hook. I know repetition is one of the most important tools in a songwriter's kit, but the fact that they follow Kiss Me with Kiss Me in the chorus strikes me as the wrong move. I can't quite put it into words, but it feels like just lazy songwriting to me. And no, the stuttering does not make it any better. It's Katie, come to kiss me! As for the lyrics as a whole... Okay, you know, I have been accused in the past of being somewhat literal-minded. I maintain that telephone isn't about anything but a telephone. I think milkshake is about a woman who makes really good milkshakes. But I realize that that may be a reductive way to interpret things. So I'm going to do my best to interpret this one a little smarter. So... aliens. Talking about someone who's strange, who's different, from a different world. I guess this could be about getting with a foreign guy, or I guess someone a different color. You know, there's some kind of interracial thing going on here. You're an Indian and Ethiopian. Something like that. And if that's where they were going with that, I don't know if they really need to hide that in a metaphor. You know, I mean, interracial relationships are really not much of a taboo anymore. If this is about, say, a black guy, just say, I want to get with this really amazing hot black guy. This black guy who people are afraid of. And who's going to abduct you. And make you his victim. Actually, now that I think about it, yeah, better leave that as a metaphor. That was a good move. Now I'm making myself uncomfortable. And I'm gonna get myself in trouble. You know what? There wasn't any mid-4. This is entirely innocent, and I have no reason at all to believe this has anything to do with some unstable black guy. Oh, hi, Kanye. Where they driving spaceships instead of cars. Well, that's good, because I'm pretty sure the man from Mars eats cars and bars. But go on. Pockets on Shrek. He said pockets on Shrek. He's given up trying to rap ideas, he's just throwing up gibberish at this point. Okay, come on, Kanye. Try and focus. Try and do something about the theme of the song. Pockets on Shrek, rockets on deck. Tell me what's next, alien sex. A little, on the nose there, Kanye. Tell me what's next, alien sex. That is what this song is about. Good job. I like the way you dispense with any attempts at lyricism or wit. And now, Kanye rewrites American Pie. My buddy Holly died, and then the 60s happened, and it was really intense, and rock and roll was involved in a lot of it. Okay, Kanye, you can do this. It's not too late to end with a couple really great lines. Come on, go, Kanye! I'ma disrobe you, then I'ma probe you. See, I'm abducted you, so I tell you what to do. I'ma disrobe you, then I'ma probe you. See, I'm Hello, police. I'd like to report an assault in progress. Like, maybe I could go with the sexy alien abduction thing on its own before that verse, but... Wow. As always, Kanye has made the metaphor much, much too literal. I mean, there's a difference between Katie singing about wanting to be brought into the light... and Kanye, who's not playing an alien in the video or the song, just straight up telling you, I abducted you and you do what I tell you to now. Like, you can't pretend that this is about anything else at this point. Kanye's not taking you into his flying saucer. He's taking you into his van at gunpoint. Ugh, this song. Out of all Katy Perry's songs, this is the one whose appeal I understand the least, though I've tried. I can say this for E.T., and for Katy Perry's music as a whole for that matter. Compared to other pop singers, she's avoided releasing redundant singles, as opposed to, say, Kesha, who's released the exact same song 4 or 5 times now. Or for that matter, Lady Gaga, who released her own Sex with Monsters song around the same time, which immediately flopped, probably because it sounded way too much like Bad Romance, right down to being literally about a bad romance. So give E.T. this, there's not another song like it on the radio. But there's probably a reason for that. I'm not sure I really wanted or needed an alien rape anthem in my life. Video's cool though. How does it end? It turns out her magical alien dream lover is in fact a naked albino black guy. You know what? I'm not even touching that one. Good night!